Brand new designs are up on the Edge Redbubble. Werewolves, spiders, FedEx amphibians, proto-crocs, and more. Go check out the Redbubble with links in the description and comments section below. At this time of year, eggs are not usually on the mind. Sure, we have eggnog and plenty of confectionaries and baked goods that need that ingredient, but eggs are just not really associated with the season for giving. Easter might be a better time for eggs. Too bad. Sorry to all those theme-obsessed weirdos, myself included.
Can I offer you a nice egg in this trying time?
A new discovery just dropped and it's an egg. A very, very cool egg. It has a baby in it.
I would like to see the baby.
Ovology is the branch of science dealing with the origin and functions of eggs. Oddly enough, there are no paleo-ovologists. Fossilized eggs have been known to science for a long time. The first scientifically documented dinosaur egg was found in the 1850s and described in 1859 as a giant bird egg. It wasn't until hundreds of Protoceratops eggs were found during the American Museum of Natural History's Central Asiatic Expeditions to Mongolia in the 1920s that dinosaur eggs were recognized as dinosaur eggs. Since then, thousands more specimens of non-avian dinosaur eggs have been found from every single group. That being said, most are just eggshells, fragments, or whole eggs, but without their contents. Eggs with contents, like embryos, are extremely rare. Every one found increases the knowledge of the evolution of avian and non-avian dinosaur fetal development. Thus we come to the beginning of the story that brought the most well-preserved dinosaur egg to science. At some point between the very late 1990s and 2000, a dinosaur egg fossil was uncovered in Shaoyi Industrial Park in Gunshan City, located in southern China. This egg was among many other fossils found in Gunshan City, but it was donated to the Yangliang Stone Natural History Museum in Nan'an, China, where it remained until 2015, and someone had enough time to take a better look at it. A staff member noticed some bones sticking out of the shell and wondered if the football-shaped object was hiding even more. Once they figured out there was an embryo skeleton in there, they realized the importance of the specimen and called some more experts in to take a look, including one of the authors of the paper which described the specimen, Weisam Ma. The egg measures 16.7 centimeters, 6.5 inches, by 7.6 centimeters, 2.99 inches. The shell is a tan color, while the matrix which fills the egg is a slightly purplish red. Within the egg is the nearly complete skeleton of the embryo within. Thanks to the egg's shape and the completeness of the skeleton, the researchers were able to identify the embryo as belonging to the Oviraptorosaur family, the parrot dinosaurs. They were one of the most bird-like of the non-bird theropod dinosaurs. Some were the size of turkeys, the size of cassowaries, while some grew up to 8 to 8.9 meters, 26 to 29 feet long. All were toothless with deep, tall beaks, and many had large bony crests atop of their skulls, similar to the shape of the keratinous crest of the cassowary. When originally found, they were thought to be egg-eating specialists due to many adult skeletons found atop nests. They were inferred to have been attempting to eat the eggs. After more eggs of the same shape were found with embryos inside, they were found to belong to the Oviraptorosaurs and that they were parents protecting their eggs to the bitter end. That being said, their beaks combined with their long arms, hands, and claws would have allowed them to consume just about anything, including eggs as well as fruits, nuts, seeds, leaves, and more. The embryo skeleton has been inferred to be preserved in the position it was when it was alive. However, it remains possible that it was moved into the position after death. Only more specimens like it will help to prove it one way or the other. Assuming it is in the position it was when it was alive, this little oviraptorid embryo tells us a lot about the development of non-avian theropod dinosaurs and provides some insight into the evolution of avian dinosaurs. The skeleton is positioned so the head is lying against the chest and pelvis. The skull is essentially parallel to the body, with the spine bent towards the blunt end of the egg. The behaviors exhibited by dinosaur embryos prior to hatching are poorly understood. In birds, embryos make a unique series of coordinated movements to get into the perfect position to hatch. This is called the tucking process. It involves three phases: pre-tucking, tucking, and post-tucking. In the pre-tucking phase, the embryo's snout is pointed towards the pointy end of the egg and between the legs and feet, with the back curling towards the blunt end of the egg. The blunt end of the egg is where the air cell is located, which is just an air-filled space in the egg. This specimen seems to be in this pre-tucking phase as it is in the same general position. The tucking phase proceeds, with the head moving to have the beak and skull pointing inward and toward the right wing. In the next phases, the head and beak become completely tucked under the right wing and move toward the torso. This results in the beak being positioned behind the right shoulder. In birds, this position is incredibly important to hatching. They need to be in this position in order to push against the shell and break out of it. It's actually a thing that if the embryo has not moved to this position, it will suffer from hatching difficulties and possibly death. This avian-style pre-tucking embryonic behavior in an Oviraptorosaur tells us that these types of avian movements evolved well before avian dinosaurs branched off from the non-avian dinosaur lineage. True, Oviraptorosaurs are quite bird-like and are in the major group that led to the avian dinosaurs, but they were still relatively distantly related. Certainly not as closely related as the Dromaeosaurs. It's possible these movements evolved much earlier than Oviraptorosaurs. More preserved embryos of Ornithischian dinosaurs are needed to explore these possibilities. This brand new keystone specimen provides another wonderful piece of evidence of the connection between birds and dinosaurs. Can't wait to see more. For more interesting stories about nature, the history of life, or what goes bump in the night, subscribe, hit the bell icon for updates, like this video, and drop a comment in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Special thanks goes to my elephant tier patrons, Thea Svensson, Staniforth Hopkins, Dinosaur, Chris Frampton, Biotaverse, Arda Bayer, and Christoph Hubinger, as well as my Tyrannosaur patrons, Iron Bladesman, Henry Brennan, Danny Van Heck, and Dana Manchester.